Good evening, everyone. Namaste, Sat Sri Akaal, Adab, and a very warm welcome to all of you. I feel filled with grace and peace and love in this distinguished presence of all our spiritual leaders, and I'm sure each and every one of you who joined us this evening is going to feel the same amount of peace and love. Atmarpit Nemiji, who is representing Pujya Gurudevshri Rakesh Bhai from the ancient Jain religion.
Pujya Gurudevshri has taught us that true change is in the transformation of ideas and beliefs and not just in the mere change of activities. And as beliefs deepen, they manifest naturally outside as action. Thus, to achieve the sustainable development goals, it is imperative for them to trickle down into daily life, into the very beliefs and ideas of nations and peoples first. In the daily culture of Shrimad Rajchandra Mission Dharampur, the environment has always been a non-negotiable part of all decision making. Whether it is a child who will refuse to hurt even a flower or a leaf because it lives just like you and me, or the adults who will avoid walking even on grass, this culture of compassion is woven into the mindsets of people. It will thus manifest in different ways across the work of the mission. Environmental care is an independently running department of the social service wing of the mission, Shrimad Rajchandra Love and Care, where we have numerous projects constantly running. But if this care for nature becomes part of your nature, it will manifest everywhere in all our activities. It is no surprise that even in the design and conceptualization of the 223-acre spiritual township, our ashram home in Dharampur, under Pujya Gurudevshri's guidance and direction, we have numerous environmental solutions and even innovations implemented that have been praised globally. It has always been Pujya Gurudevshri's directive that the noble ones always give back more than they take, even from the land and the surroundings. Besides rainwater harvesting and the use of solar energy for not only the ashram space but the adjoining schools and colleges also, the ashram will soon be feeding energy back into the state grid. As per Pujya Gurudevshri's directive of creating near zero waste, there has been intense local innovation. We created a local recycling facility here itself to reuse the excavated soil and sand into the construction of the ashram itself. Due to this, there was also a considerable reduction in consumption of construction and building material. There are many such initiatives, whether it is segregation of waste or sewage treatment through SBT, which is a soil biotechnology for treating and reusing sewage water for landscaping, through which we potentially save up to 37 crore liters of water per year. When we had acquired our ashram land in 2000, it was barren due to deforestation over many years. Today, through our afforestation program, we have revived the land and the green cover is lush and the soil renewed. Since the coming of Pujya Gurudevshri to this land, there has been a massive shift in its very topography. And it is predicted that in a few years, the mean temperature of the land will also decrease by 2 to 3 degrees. This is no small matter for the welfare of the people of the land. No matter how small or big, these are all mere manifestations. Simple choices made daily, but the real power at its root lies in faith and culture that creates lifestyles. Sustainable development can only happen on the strong bedrock of faith and an ever-expanding ahimsa, which is compassion, where caring for nature actually becomes your nature. And the greater your love, the further your care and compassion will reach. And your lifestyle itself will then become one where you always give back more than you take. Thank you.
Thank you so much for that. It is true that it's always the noble ones that give back more than they can take.